Let me introduce you to a young lady who has a distinction, a number of distinctions. Not only is she one of the most talented up-and-coming singer-songwriters in the American folk music circuit, she also paid a fortune today and took a taxi cab here. Cab driver said, Shanksville? He couldn't even understand English, and he could hardly pronounce Shanksville. And when she finally got here and got on stage for the one of the afternoon workshops, she got a standing ovation. So we had a special slot set aside just for her, and we're going to open up that slot right now, introduce you to perhaps someone you know, Christine Lavin. You know Christine.
Hi, everybody. This is my very, very first time at the Philadelphia Folk Festival, and I'm real excited to be here, and my feet are a little bit muddy because I missed all the exciting camping that goes on here. Are any of you campers in the audience? Okay. I've got a song for you. This is my tribute to camping, and in the middle of the song, I'll tell you when, I would like you all to make the wild animal noises, your favorite wild animal of the camping scene, so when that comes up, be ready, okay? And this is dedicated to all of you hardy souls. Oh, I'm in love with a man who loves to camp. He camps when it's sunny, he camps when it's damp. All he needs is a tent, a sleeping roll, a package of hot dogs and a sack of charcoal. He camps in the desert, he camps in the snow. He says, baby, come with me. I say no. Cause see, I like hot showers and I like ice. The cool cotton cheese on my bed feels so nice. I'm afraid of little animals, I'm scared of big bugs. I like the feel of bare feet on a Berber rug. I can't stand Porter Sands, community soap. I say, baby, stay with me. He says, nope. So I said, why do you pride yourself on the creature comforts? It's taken men so long to invent. And he said something about Walden, the row on back to Woodstock. Give his life in a tent, and then he went, oh. Okay, here, can you make all your favorite wild animal noises? Louder, louder! Oh, see how scary that is? I'm petrified. Oh, I can picture him now by a babbling brook. Slapping at mosquitoes, slipping bed on a hook. I can see the bears sniffing around for something to steal. Oh, bears, eat the hot dogs, don't make my baby oatmeal. This whole scenario, it gave me such a fright to think he could have stayed with me tonight. Where my air conditioner makes a real cool breeze. Not unlike the wind, whistling through the trees. I got stars on my ceiling that glow in the dark. I'll open up the windows, we can hear the birds in the park. I'll put Wild Kingdom on my TV. Not be camping, but it's pretty close. Oh, honey, I like as primitive as you want me to be. This might not be camping, but it's close enough for me. Thank you. Thank you. By the way, that song contains one of my most popular love tips for girls. I do have stars on my ceiling that glow in the dark because I live in New York where you can't see the real sky. And there's one man in my life whose first name begins with an M. So I put this M of stars up there, and then I have a dimmer switch so I can play the sun goes down and the stars come out, and there's this big M in the sky. I said, look, sweetheart, that's for you. And he says, oh, give me some sugar, Christine. And he has no idea that's a W for somebody else. And if you look at a cockeyed, it could be an E. So, girls, do it. It works. Okay, my next song is dedicated to all of you women out there who are, like, reaching that certain age where you look at babies and you start to get this palpitation in your bosom. And I wrote it to the ticking of a clock. I don't have a clock here, so instead I've got a little metronome. Can you hear that? Listen, girls. Do you hear something ticking? I do. It's inside me, it's inside you. A biological time bomb. Oh, you can barely hear it when you're 20. But when you're 30, it's plenty louder. Your mother warned you, but no, you had to doubt her. I've got plenty of time, Mom. Oh. The ticking echoes in that empty womb, empty womb, empty womb, empty womb. Oh, from the next apartment, D Did you hear that boom? Her biological time bomb. Now every time you see a baby carriage, you curse the years you have avoided marriage. You are angry, you are confused. But wait, I have figured out how to defuse the biological time bomb. First you have a dozen of your eggs aspirated, frozen in the freezer of a doctor's refrigerator. In 10 or 20 or 30 years, whenever you wish, you thaw them out to romance wigglies in a petri dish. Then plant the little goober in a girl of 17 who's into natural living and prevention magazine. No fuss, no muss, no stretch marks. Well, not on you. Maternal instincts satisfy the modern thing to do. Listen, girls. You can't ignore that ticking any longer. As you grow older, it will grow stronger. Biological time bomb. Biological time bomb. Biological. Thank you! I know, that's a sick song. And I apologize, but I'll tell you something. If Christie Brinkley was selling some of her goobers, I get mixed up when I use technical terms. But anyway, if she was selling some of them, I think I might buy one. Who do you think would be good to match up with Christie Brinkley if you're going to make a little... Mate, yeah, you want it done the old-fashioned way, though. I kind of have my heart set on Pee Wee Herman and Christie Brinkley getting together. Well, I'd like to do one more song for you and then turn the show over to, I don't know, the next person. But this is a song that I wrote when I was in Lenox Hill Hospital in New York City. And what happened is this man came up to me after a show. He said, you know, you write love songs, but they're not normal. And I said, thank you, because I thought he was complimenting me, but he wasn't. He said, why can't you write something really sweet and romantic? And I thought, yeah, I'd really like to. So then I got real sick, and I was in the hospital, and I was in a semi-private room, and they doped me up. And there was a woman in the next bed, and she was hooked up to what looked like a Pac-Man machine. It was keeping her alive. She was no fun at all. You know, she wouldn't let me use her TV set or anything. And so I was thinking about her, and I was thinking about writing a love song, a romantic love song. Then I started thinking about a store on West 4th Street in Greenwich Village where you can buy marital aids and sex gadgets. And all this swirled around, you know the place, you little hussy. All of this swirled around in my brain because I was all doped up and I wrote this song, but I wanted you to know I was trying to write a sweet romantic love song, but I wrote this instead. Johnny and Jane, they were the perfect married couple, but not in bed. Oh, they tried taking drugs, how-to books, even Dr. Ruth, but for all intents and purposes, their love life was dead. Till one day Jane went over to the Pink Pussycat Boutique. She bought a long cylindrical fan. Now JD is smiling, Johnny is not. Every night you can hear him sing. He says our love is being kept alive by artificial means. You've grown emotionally attached to that little pink machine. Our relationship is not as healthy as it seems, cause our love is being kept alive by artificial means. Okay, I hope you're listening. This is a sing-along, but only for people who have sexual problems, okay? So, the rest of you, be still, and you poor troubled souls, sing out, and later on you'll be thanking me again and again and again. Oh, Johnny went down to the barroom. He bought one drink, he bought two, he bought three. Oh, he moaned to the bartender, the state of his married life. Bartender said, hey, bud, just listen to me. So Johnny went over to the Pink Pussycat Boutique. He bought a plastic blow-up doll. Now Johnny is smiling, Janie is not. She's angry, she is jealous, she's appalled. She says our love is being kept alive by artificial means. You've grown emotionally attached to that polyethylene. Our relationship is not as healthy as it seems, cause our love is being kept alive by artificial means. That was great singing, especially you people in the back. Terrific. Wires, switches, batteries, plastic, tufts of poly. babies died at the same moment that that big doll sprung a leak. Johnny looked at Janie, looked at Johnny, looked at Janie. Oh, they both found it difficult to speak. I wish I could say they threw those contraptions away and fell in love all over again. But Johnny taped up that hissing woman when Janie stole the batteries from his Sony Walkman. Because their love is being kept alive by artificial means, they've grown emotionally attached to these modern sex machines. Their relationship is not as healthy as it seems, 'cause their love is being kept alive. Love is being kept alive. Love is being kept alive by artificial means. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Ain't she fun? That's Christine Lavin. She has a new recording out, a new album coming out, and a single, and she's, you just watch out for that young lady. Christine Lavin.